FSN Radio. It's all about what's next. Go to financialsurvivalnetwork.com and sign up for your free weekly newsletter. You'll also get three free reports. The Financial Survival Network. It's all about what's next.
And we are back on the Financial Survival Network. You're listening to Carrie Lutz. With us now, the master of the trend, publisher of the Trends Journal, Gerald Celente. Gerald, welcome back to the show.
Hey, thanks for having me, Carrie.
Hey, always a pleasure. So a couple of things. I want to get to your latest economic prognostications, but first, from your latest edition, Summer Trends Journal, you know, talking about the way people see themselves, the way that you dress, and the food that you put in your body, been a marked deterioration. You talk about an economic collapse, but a perception, a self-respect collapse that's taken place in the last two generations of Americans and probably around the world, right?
Yeah, it is. Basically, it is. It's spreading around the world, and it's spreading as obesity spreads. And China, in Asia, you know, they're eating the American diet of highly processed junk foods, and you can see it in the people. And you see it in the people, you hear it in the music, you listen to it on the street, it's everywhere. And there's a very obvious lack of dignity, self-respect, and passion. I never remember as a young guy growing up people riding down the aisles of supermarkets on electric cars because they're so obese they can't walk. And, you know, we're up here in Colonial Kingston, New York, and we have an old supermarket is our headquarters, the old Mohegan Market. They have these big windows out there on the street. And it's a procession of whales and hippopotamuses and elephants. And I'm saying this in all truthfulness. And another thing I've noticed is that everybody's doing one of the four things. As they're walking, they're either speaking on their phones, they're either texting, they're eating, or they're drinking something. And it was never like this before. And then you look at the dress, and, you know, going to a sporting event is, you know, it's a freak show. I was old enough to remember when people used to get dressed up when they used to get on the airlines, you know, taking a plane. Now it's a flying circus. You go to a fine restaurant, in the old days you had to be dressed up. You didn't get in. It was part of the atmosphere, and the atmosphere changed with the dress. Now you could hear people yelling from three tables away as if they own the whole joint, and they could care less about you. So the story is, don't blame Obamacare, blame I don't care. We do have the most expensive healthcare system in the world, and you could have it, you know, the best. It's not going to make any difference. Not when you're seeing type 2 diabetes escalating. This never happened before. Kids didn't have this. And obesity is going to be the greatest plague that's going to hit the nation. And not only our nation, others. You're looking at a lot of cancers related to obesity, numerous health problems. So, and then again, it goes back to the quality of the food. Look at the junk. Go into the supermarket, you see a stretch of so-called soft drinks that are the whole aisle. And so it's, and although, you know, I'm a political atheist, so I don't take sides on political, you know, so I say something about a politician. Oh, it's not because I don't like them. I don't like any of them.
For good reason.
Make it clear.
For good reason.
And so what I'm about to say is that, you know, the liberals who love Clinton, Bill, they forget that this is the guy that brought them GMOs. Mm-hmm. This is the guy that brought them bovine growth hormones. Slick Willie's the guy that allowed the drug companies to advertise on TV. They weren't allowed to advertise on TV before that, among other atrocities that he committed with, you know, Iraq and Serbia. But those are just side notes, you know, and deregulating the communications industry is another one, by the way.
So, like, you look at this and, you know, it's just shocking. Just take a trip to the mall. And like you said, you see these electric carts, which Medicare is paying for them. And that's a massive fraud in itself. All of these electric wheelchairs and scooters and everything else. There was just an article about that. Hundreds of millions of dollars worth of fraud. They just got their hands around that after 15 years. But, you know, it's this lack of self-respect because you do have alternatives. You don't have to have a double gulp soda. You can actually drink water or, you know, some type of juice. But yet, why do Americans just go for the for the mega dose of calories, Gerald? What is it in our character that has just numbed us to the healthy choice? I'm just not getting it, I guess, because look, up until recently, you know, I kind of was predisposed to that. And then I made the decision that, look, I got type 2 diabetes. The only way I'm getting rid of it is to lose 20 pounds. And I did it. And you know what? It went away. It went away, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm still predisposed to it, but as long as I don't go have five donuts at Dunkin' Donuts or Krispy Kreme, my blood sugar's in check. It's really that simple.
Yeah, I know. The first book I worked on was Natural Healing back in the mid-80s. My former wife was very sick with colitis, and I went on a whole crusade in trying to cure her because they wanted to do that massive operation where you could actually take your anus out, put a bag in, and take out your... Yeah. And I did, and that's how, you know, she totally healed. Mm-hmm. And so I also have an honorary doctorate in integrative medicine from the National University of Health Sciences.
Yeah.
So I've been at this a lot of years. And, you know, it's just, I mean, yeah, it's not easy for anybody. I love to eat. I'm Italian, you know, I mean, it's,
yeah.
You know, I mean, really, you know, it's about, but there's another part of my, you mentioned about the fraud of Medicare.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for many years, you know, being a business owner, and I try to stay away from the doctors because I try to really take care of myself. I would just have catastrophic care.
Uh-huh.
And in New York State, I could buy this Empire Blue Cross Blue Shield. These cost me like $600 a year.
They won't let you do that anymore, of course.
No, you know, I'm paying triple the amount more for Medicare. Because I'm over, you know, I'm 67.
Right.
I'm paying triple the amount that I was, more, on Medicare. And then I had to get another plan to go on top of it to cover the other 20%. Because, again, you know, if I only want it for catastrophic. So if I end up with something really serious and paying 20% of something really serious, that's big dough.
Yeah, that'll break you.
Yeah. So anyway, so when you mentioned Medicare, the fraud, the whole, it's one fraud from top to bottom. It's the immoral wars that they're fighting. Hey, how about that humanitarian mission? We saved those Christians on the mountain in Iraq. Oh, yeah, now they're bombing the hell out of them over the ISIS over there, you know, and helping those Kurds, our pals the Kurds, another BS excuse for more militarization, for more war, as the country goes down the crapper, and they keep stealing our dough.
Well, we need more military orders to the contractors, right? Because they're not making enough money. Right. We got to be
what Eisenhower warned us about.
Yeah. So but it's just I can't figure out why, like, you always go for the 32 ounces of Coke rather than 32 ounces of water. Is that like a brain thing? Is that like societal?
It's societal. People, you know. Yeah. And it's really just a It happens at so many different levels. I'm really convinced, Kerry, it happens with music, and I'll tell you why. You know, I mentioned, you know, I'm of Italian descent.
Sure.
And the Italians had nearly a bloodless revolution in the 1800s. You know, because in the 1800s, you know, Germany, Austria, Hungary, France, Spain, the Neapolitan, they all had a piece of the action. They were all occupying different places of Italy. And the Calabrese and the Neapolitans basically spoke a different language. It was one of the missions of Giuseppe Verdi, of course, the great composer, to unite Italy. And his passion was to do it with music. And he did. He used music to instill the spirit within the Italian people to overthrow their repressors. It's a fact.
Uh-huh.
The model exists. And it was nearly a bloodless revolution. You ask about, you know, who are the great Italian war heroes, where they come up with, like, you know, one or two guys, you know, and that's about it. And because nobody knows, because there wasn't that kind of fighting. The people did it. And then you go back, let's fast forward, and I'm on the phone, we're off the air. I said, listen, Kerry, I want to talk to you about this great idea I have. We're going to take the lowest common denominator of society, the people in prison, that we don't give shoelaces to or belts to, because they'll strangle people with them or kill them with them.
Right.
And we're going to take their language and their dress style, and we're going to create music and a fashion style from it. We're going to call it gangster rap. We're going to the lowest common denominator in civilization, and we're going to make that the model for young people to aspire to. You get off the phone and you say to your producer, who's this lunatic we just had on? Who's this sick man? He must be a lowlife from Hollywood. He must be one of those slime balls that would sell out their mother to make a dollar. Yeah. That's who they are. And yeah, they did it. So you asked why people drink crap, talk like crap, and look like crap? Hollywood.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's right there in front of everybody's face, and they don't want to call a spade a spade. That's who they are. The lowest slime on earth. The music industry and the movie industry. They sell you shit, and the people buy it. They listen to it on TV. They see it in the streets. It's in the advertisements, and they pop up the lowlifes. We have a photo in the Trends Journal of Sarah Vaughan singing and Miley Cyrus. You want to see a freak show? There she is.
I'm looking at it right now, and I laughed when I saw it. It's just, yeah. The contrast, and then there's a picture of Cary Grant dressed so dapperly, and then there's these gangster rappers, and then the picture of people dining on the airplane with white glove service, and then a guy eating a slice of pizza out of a box and the strings of cheese, and it's just turns your stomach, you know?
And it's just not even cheese. It's
yeah,
fake
whatever
cheese.
It is. Yeah, government cheese.
Yeah, government cheese. That could be. That's it. They should. They call that the press conferences. They have government cheese. You know.
And you just like, what are we coming to here?
I know. I'm old enough to remember. I was flying first class around 1974. Mm-hmm. You know, I used to be a top government affairs specialist for the chemical industry, by the way, D.C. and Chicago.
Better living so, through and, chemistry. And,
well, you know, that's how I learned what I learned. I was on the other side, mm-hmm. you know, and I was at 23, I was the assistant to the secretary of the New York State Senate. Mm-hmm. Well, you know, so I was in the system, so I know what it looked. But anyway, I used to fly, and I remember they used to ask you, do you want lobster thermidor or a prime roast? I'm serious. That was just first class.
I know. And gone are the days. And yeah, you used to get dressed up to go on the plane. I remember wearing a jacket and, you know, it was a big event. And now it's an Airbus, literally.
Yeah. It's steerage class.
Yeah. Steerage. And yeah, so getting to this collapse now. So we see, except in certain areas of the country, just housing prices going down, you know, for rent signs all over, for sale signs. And, you know, Walmart sales have been going down. I think it's five straight quarters. Their sales have gone down. I mean, you know, now we're finding out that one of their largest contributors to sales are EBT cards, right? And that's been cut back. So their sales have been cut back. So it's a slow moving, slow motion collapse, kind of like when you see on TV, the cars kind of collide in the race. You know, it happens real slowly, but it's happening nonetheless, isn't it?
Hey, well, it's not only here. You look, go to the China Daily.
Yeah.
And you'll see, you know, home prices declined in like, you know, 67 out of 70 cities. Home prices declining in London. Mm-hmm. It's going global. Look at oil prices. Oil prices don't lie. Yeah. I mean, you know, sure, they manipulate the markets to an extent, but I follow this stuff every day. Oil's been on a downward, and I would have thought the prices would have gone up. Demand is so soft that now you're looking at Brent crude going under a dollar.
Under $100 a barrel there. Yeah. Amazing. Yep. And gasoline, you know, it's all over the place.
Yep. So. Yep. Yeah. So we're looking at a situation here where it's a global slowdown.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So what are they going to do? They're going to print more money, right?
That's what they're. That's the big problem. They can't print because they have to. You're hearing about the tapering going on. They know that we're in a bubble, and it has to at some point. They're going to have to raise interest rates when.